Good morning, San Francisco, and welcome to the third day of the first Dutch virtual trade mission on smart and e-mobility. It's 7:15 here in San Francisco, and it's great to have you here again at the Consulate General in the heart of Silicon Valley. If you have any questions today, please leave them in the chat box that you can find under your viewer. And if you want to share about this trade mission on social media, please do use the hashtag NLUSA, hashtag Digitale Missie, and tag us, the Consulate, at NL in SF. And you might have guessed it, today's topic is cycling, because we have this beautiful wooden bike in front of our desk right now. Gerrit, did you bike to work on this one today? What is this?
Oh, I wish. Instead, I drove to work in my car, my e-Golf. However, I did bring my bikes, of course, to San Francisco. But it's a bit hilly here, you know, and luckily electric bikes are very common. Even in quite a lot of bike sharing programs. So, Sietse, you are using those kind of bikes, isn't it?
Yeah, I use the bike sharing program always. And what I love here in San Francisco is that they have electric options as well, which is very convenient if you cycle to work with all those hills, of course. And I'm actually really excited. So I have a little girl at home. She's 7 months old. And once daycare opens, I have to bring her to daycare, of course. And I want to get a real Dutch bakfiets, a cargo bike. And luckily, they have them electric as well. So I can go over the hills with my girl to daycare. So I'm really excited for that. So as you can understand, cycling is almost as Dutch as cheese, tulips and wooden shoes. And if I have to explain to my American friends what cycling is like in the Netherlands, I just show them this video. So this lady here in yellow is the Queen of the Netherlands. She's Queen Maxima, and she just opened a museum because that's what queens do. So and after opening the museum, she just gets on her bike and bikes home back to the palace.
Ah, and her bodyguard bikes too.
Her bodyguard's bikes too. I think it's no security risks there. And then I showed them this picture. This is Amsterdam Central Station. This is the bike parking at Amsterdam Central Station. And you might think, that's amazing. There's so many park space for bikes. Well organized, Netherlands. But I'm like, you see how full it is. I can never find a parking spot when I have to park my bike. I have to circle around, find a spot. It's almost like being in a car and trying to find a parking spot in your car. And then this last picture, this is the Prime Minister of the Netherlands, Mark Rutte, and he also bikes. So he had a visit, he visited the king in the palace. And even the Prime Minister of the Netherlands has to lock his bike in front of a palace while the security guards are watching.
Well, you can't trust anyone these days, I would say. So it's really great to see how biking culture is improving in San Francisco. And of course, it's improving in Los Angeles as well, which is known as a car city, actually. We brought a delegation last year, November, to Los Angeles. And we tried to explore the opportunities for cycling and biking infrastructure.
I'm here representing the Netherlands Minister for the Environment. I came to California with a delegation of about 35 companies, 50 people from the Netherlands in the areas of circular economy, smart mobility, sustainable mobility, as well as climate resilience. And we're here to really find new contacts and new contracts with California Parks. California, like the Netherlands, has a very ambitious climate agenda. California wants to be climate neutral in 2045, and what they're looking for is solutions, which the Dutch can offer in many ways to help them reach that target. The participants in the delegation are bringing with them a number of solutions to the issues that we see here in California as well. For an example, the combination of different modalities. Combining car, bike, and public transport is something where a lot can be gained also in California.
Well, that was a very successful trade mission. And you know, one of the participants was Maurits Lopez Cardoso of Bike Minded. Maurits, you're joining us in this virtual trade mission as well. How was the follow-up of last year's mission, and why did you decide to join us here again in this virtual trade mission?
Yeah, good morning, and thank you, Herbert. In the November mission last year, we had great meetings, specifically around the bicycling topic. For instance, with the mayor office in Los Angeles and also with the city of Davis. So now as a follow-up, we are organizing a Dutch Mobility Week to bring together Dutch transportation experts and Californian transportation experts. And we do this together with the Dutch consulate in San Francisco, the Dutch Cycling Embassy, an NGO in the Netherlands, that brings together a whole wide range of cycling experts and also public parties. So the Dutch Mobility was scheduled for April, but due to the COVID situation, we had to reschedule to mid-November. That's what we're looking at right now. And so after the summer, we're planning some webinars and online events to further introduce and set the stage for the Dutch Mobility Week. So stay tuned for that.
Wonderful. So a very successful follow-up, actually. And what's BikeMinded currently doing in LA?
Oh, BikeMinded is working on the LA River Bike Path project for LA Metro. And the LA River Bike Path project is a new bicycle and pedestrian path along the LA River. And it will close the largest gap that's currently there in the bike route, close to the downtown area. Once complete, this bike route will be a seamless 32-mile long, grade-separated regional corridor. And you could see it kind of as the bicycling, future bicycling backbone of Los Angeles. BikeMinded is proud to be part of the design team, and our team is commissioned to design and engineer this project. It will be in place for the 2028 Olympics. And BikeMinded works on the concept development and of the bicycle facilities and the structural designs that are needed for this project.
Well, thank you. And of course, there's a lot going on because of the preparations of the Olympics, of course. Measure M, we'll talk about it later in LA on the Move. There's really a lot happening in LA when it comes to transportation and cycling. And I would like to turn to Kevin Chin. He works for the Los Angeles County Bicycle Coalition, which promotes cycling in LA. And Kevin, what's the biking culture like in LA? And what are your challenges?
Well, good morning. Good morning, everyone. And thanks for allowing me to be here. The biking culture in LA is growing. It's, people think of LA as a car city, but we have a lot of cyclists. We actually have a sizable number of people who ride their bikes every day, whether that is to and from work directly or who use it as a part of public transportation in order to cover that first last mile. And it's something that is changing in a rapid way, especially now with the COVID situation. You see fewer people driving. They don't have their commutes. And so people have turned to biking as a form of recreation, but also as a way to get around their neighborhoods and just to enjoy exploring their communities.
Well, and I think there was this number I read, like I think the commute in Los Angeles, less than 1% is, a bike commute. Is that correct?
Yes, absolutely. The number sounds small, but you have to remember the LA region is 10 million people. So even though that's a fairly small percentage, it ends up being a rather large number. And that number is oftentimes actually underreported because LA actually has a lot of riders who are riders out of necessity rather than choice. You have a lot of folks, especially in lower income communities, communities of color that work, jobs very early, that start very early in the morning or very late at night. Many of those people, their commutes are by bike oftentimes, and oftentimes those people don't get counted in a lot of those official estimates.
And your challenges, actually, because of course, this number is very low. You might have a lot. Please tell us a bit about your challenges.
Sure. LA is probably the biggest challenge with LA is just how big it all is. The spread of LA is enormous. We LA County reaches from where I am down in Long Beach all the way up to the very northern tip of the Antelope Valley. And so just, trying to cover that kind of distance on a bike for a lot of people, that's an unrealistic unrealistic option. So I think it's important to just remember, like, the sprawl and the size of LA makes it very challenging. So it's important for us to actually be able to link biking to public transit, and having public transit infrastructure that is very robust and is able to accommodate a lot of cyclists is a great way to ensure that we're able to consider all of these alternative options. The other piece is, of course, growing bike culture. You know, LA is known as a car city, and we've invested a lot of money in developing car infrastructure, not so much in biking infrastructure. We actually currently lack a interconnected network. And, you know, LA is, the LA region is composed of actually 88 cities. So getting all of those cities to work together and work closely to develop a interconnected network of bike routes and bike lanes is actually really challenging to do, because every city has different needs, every city has different requirements, every city has different funding. So we, as the Bike Coalition, really are trying to work with all of these different municipalities to kind of develop that understanding of how to put together an appropriate network that will interconnect the entire region and allow people to ride their bikes everywhere.
Well, that's indeed these are challenges. And I would just like to ask both you and Maurits a question, because due to the COVID-19, there is an increase and an increased demand for electric bikes. And well, both for you, the question, what do you see as changes in our biking habits as a result of this COVID-19? Maybe Maurits, you first.
Sure. Thanks. Yeah, that's really interesting to see what's happening at the moment. Yeah, I get it through the news and my network. I hear things, you know, cycling picking up all around the globe, basically. I think it's now is really a big opportunity to plan and invest and really put the dot on the horizon and develop cycling to be a viable transportation alternative. And I think what Kevin just said, making the public transportation bicycle connection has a huge potential. In the Netherlands, that's also a really important part of the mobility puzzle. And also making this complete bicycle network, connecting all the different destinations with continuous infrastructure. I've heard that now on the residential level, lots of streets are opening up and there's more space kind of being found for cyclists at the moment. And I think now is the best moment to build on that and plan further and really think about those complete networks. And I want to emphasize, I see a large potential for the use of e-bicycles and faster bicycles, assisted bicycles, to as an alternative in this sprawl situation, Kevin, as you said, you know, distances are larger and the climate, it can be quite hot. But if you have seamless and safe and attractive infrastructure for all ages and abilities, and you combine that with the potential of e-bikes that can cover longer distances and make it more accessible for a larger user group, I mean, there's really serious transportation potential right there.
Okay.
And so for me, it's really a key element of smart mobility.
Yeah, great opportunity. Kevin, a short answer from your side, please.
Sure. And I think Maurits is right that e-bikes are a big part of how we're going to really get to, you know, change that culture. I think they're a great bridge between people who are looking to get out of their cars for the very first time and to sort of experience biking. We need to get the infrastructure in place, but having the option of e-bikes is also helpful. And, you know, what we're seeing right now during the current health crisis is that more and more people are using biking as a way to recreate in their neighborhoods. And we're hoping that that translates into when things start to get back to some semblance of normality. We hope that those people will continue to use biking as a part of their day-to-day lives instead of going back to a car.
Yeah, we all hope. I think, and just wanted to say that you're both on our interactive platform. So if there are more questions, well, all the participants can easily reach out to both of you. We'd like to thank you so much. I would like now to turn to our colleague of the recently opened Netherlands Business Support Office in Los Angeles, Danielle Berden. Daniela, you've lived for about 15 years in Los Angeles. You've seen the city for quite a while. And what do you feel about the biking culture in Los Angeles, the city well known for its cars?
Yes, I first of all, thanks for having us. I totally agree with Kevin. LA is enormous. It's very hard to compare it to the Netherlands. We have such a huge area. I do see that there is a real effort right now from the city to help with the infrastructure. So there is a mobility plan of 2035 where they really are trying to create more biking paths, individual paths. I think since 2010, they have installed more than 50 miles of bikeways, so which is great. So it really shows you that they are working on mobility and opportunities here in LA. And, you know, it's great, Kevin and Moritz, the incentives and the e-bike program is fantastic. I do see as well, as Kevin said, due to the COVID, there is an enormous run on bikes. The bikes, you know, there's a new saying, like, bikes are the new toilet paper. It's very popular. Everybody realizes it's great for exercising. It's healthy. It's good for the environment. And I think the city also really realizes it's not just, you know, for going to the beach and having fun, but it's really part of the economic development strategy of the city now. So it's really great.
Yeah. Well, you were recently appointed as deputy chief representative of the MBSO in Los Angeles. So what does the MBSO do in Los Angeles for Dutch entrepreneurs that want to conduct business?
Yeah, of course. We are the Netherlands Business Support Office. So we are really hands-on helping Dutch entrepreneurs who want to open businesses here in LA. So very practical, giving them information, networking, working with government entities, helping them, you know, what to do, you know, because LA is very big. Most people have no idea. It's very good for us to set a realistic picture of what it's like to do business here, what are the pitfalls, and we really help them and support them in setting up a business here to be successful.
Wonderful. And we've set up office hours, and you're available later today as well for take-in and just for a first sort of meeting online. Sietse, back to you.
Thank you, Gerbert. Before I walk you all through the program of today, I have a couple of announcements for all the participants. So today, all the sessions that come after us, they will take place through a number of different tools. So please check out the platform, the agenda in the platform, to find out where your meeting is and how where you can find the meeting. And if you look in the agenda, you can find the right link to each meeting. Later today is the matchmaking session. If you're done with your assigned meeting, please join the parallel session where you can find different breakout rooms with different interesting contacts. People from the consulate will be there. The NBSO will be there. So that's a great alternative for your matchmaking meeting. Now, let me go through the program of today for all the participants. So we started with Good Morning San Francisco. Right after this is LA on the Move. And also parallel to that, a session on heavy duty batteries, followed by a fourth webinar, Cities Leading the Electrification Charge. And right after that, we have the matchmaking session and the virtual office hours. So that's the parallel session. That's it for now. Thank you so much for joining, and we'll see you tomorrow.